I knew very early on that the music was going to be a very, very important part to this movie, as I think it ought to be. I think music is a huge part of the Zelda franchise as a whole, and it's more than just something that's pretty to listen to. I think, you know, going back to Ocarina of Time, you know, the music was alive, and the music affected the world. The music made it rain, or it made day turn to night, or it took you from one place to the next. We do certainly want the music to be more than just something that you listen to. It is something that, in a way, takes you from one place to the next. And I have been working very diligently to convey that through the music, so that it's not going to be just some generic fantasy music. It's very, very, very integral to the story and integral to the characters. Most every character has a very distinct theme. And I think it does very well, especially for the new characters, with establishing them as a person. But actually, on a pretty equal level, the legacy characters, I guess you could call them, because the scene specifically where Link meets Zelda, it was not living up to my potential when it was all edited together. The sound effects were there, and you know, it looked good, but then the music made it great. It just didn't feel like Princess Zelda without a little Zelda's lullaby. And that's been something that's been very fun for me composing it. It has just been, you know, finding the little moments here or there where you can interject a little familiar theme, where maybe it doesn't take control of the entire melody, but it's just enough that it conjures up that nostalgia of what it was like playing that game while hearing that music. So I'm very proud of what we have so far regarding that. Regarding it is original music. It's not just a copy and paste from the games, but there are many aspects that mirror the games, and I think people will have a lot of fun just feeling very familiar while watching the film. And I think the music is very, very helpful in that. The characterization has been one of my favorite parts, because honestly, the music completes the character. I mean, you have, you know, it goes from a concept sketch and a script, you know, to a live actor saying the words and a costume that actor is wearing. And they put their own portrayal, and they put, really, they create the character, but then there's still that something that's missing until you get the music. And I think, I hope that people feel the same way when they watch the movie, that they feel that the characters are fully fleshed out through the music that they're hearing when they see them. So that's been something that has been really fun just to play around with, because you know, you think of the script as the story, but in this film, the music is absolutely essential and absolutely integral, and it would not be the same film without it. So I hope that passion comes through when people watch the film. I hope that, you know, people respond the same way I did when I first put the film and the music together. I hope it just creates a very nostalgic environment for them, and I really hope it brings them a lot of joy, you know, to see something that they grew up with turned into something live. And I know that's been something that has profoundly impacted me throughout this whole process. It's just been literally getting to live my childhood. Like, you know, you'd be standing in the middle of the woods, you know, dressed as Link, pulling the Master Sword out of a pedestal, and that moment, you're just kind of like, man, I'm living my childhood. And if I'm completely honest, that's why I started it. That's why I started this film, was, you know, to preserve a part of my childhood and put forth kind of what my interpretation of The Legend of Zelda is and what it is to me, and how it's impacted me, and I want to show that impact to others through this film.